Still checking in the place with cold. Moving in the way, no place, no snow. Straight to the room, my niggas that shiver. Thinking about South Lake. What's up, everybody? It's King Wolf. Welcome to today's Defensive Basics video. Now, a lot of people do not know or understand the idea behind base aligning on defense. And I'm going to go ahead and give you just a brief explanation. You know, one good thing about it and then one very bad thing about base aligning, when you shouldn't base align. So for this example right here, we're going to go ahead and go out of the gun bunch right here. It's a bunch formation. We're going to go ahead and use the wide receiver post. That's going to be our base play on offense so you guys can see what base aligning does against plays like this. Now, what is base aligning? Base aligning is pretty much all it means is in your play art. So if we go over here to nickel normal, and then cover three sky. If you look at the play art right there, that play art right there is in base align. That's what base align is. That is your defense. I mean, your not your defense. That's your default setup, defensive setup, where all your backs are supposed to be on defense. So base aligning on defense pretty much just tells your defense to go to their default positions. Because what happens is, since I picked the bunch play on offense, your defense is going to align to compensate for that formation. Now, there's a good thing about base aligning, and there's a bad thing about base aligning. I'm going to explain it to you guys in this video right here. So let's go ahead and run to the cover three sky on defense, okay? So here's our play right here. That's our play art. It's pretty much just a drag and a crossing route. Very simple, very easy. But if you look at our defense, these guys are not in their default positions, okay? They're compensating for the bunch formation on offense. Now, what base aligning does is it sends them back to their default positions, the way they're supposed to be as far as the play art goes. Now, why do you want to do that? Well, a lot of people base align because if you're learning a nickel defense and you want to stay within a nickel defense and you're running a Tampa 2, if you keep base aligning on Tampa 2, you're going to start to pick up on what your defensive backs are doing, where the weak spot of your defense is when you're playing your opponents. They're not going to line up to the offense no more. Everybody's going to play their default positions and run to their default zones when you use base align, which is good, but it's also bad in a way. Another good thing about base aligning is if you're going to be sending blitzes, you want to make sure that your blitzes are consistent. That's why you see a lot of nano blitzes. They all tell you to baseline at the very start. Baseline, that way, that blitz will always come through. It has a greater chance of coming through if you're using the same setup over and over. So as the offense is changing their offensive formation, your defense is going to stay the same as far as the play art goes. So that is a plus. So let me go ahead and explain, show you guys what happens in base align. So right here on our defense, my phone's ringing. I'm sorry about that. So right here, we have not base aligned our defense. So what we're going to do first is we're going to base align them. And what that's going to do, it's going to tell everybody on defense to go to their default positions, the way the art look on that play. So press Y or triangle, and you're going to put the left stick to the right for base align. Now I want you to pay attention to what happens to everybody on defense when we do that. Right stick to the right, everybody goes to where they're supposed to be. Safeties go to where they're supposed to be. Corners and linebackers go where they're supposed to be. Now, everybody's going to play defense the way the play is designed, on, you know, as far as the default setup. Now, like I said, it's good for sending in blitzes. Now, where you're going to get screwed is you do not want to baseline if you're running man defense. So let's go ahead and let me show you guys what I mean by that. So like I said, two good things about base aligning. You can, you know, keep sending blitzes and you'll know which ones are going to come in, which aren't. And you're going to get to know your defense a lot better. You know, you're going to know what they're doing in weak spots as far as that Tampa 2 cover 2. And you can make adjustments after you base align. You can, you know, send people in flat zones. You can send people in hook zones, you know, deep zones, whatever. So let's go ahead and go back to the same thing. Gun bunch, wide receiver post, right? Now let's go back to this. And let's go ahead and pick a man defense. Cover two man. Now, here's our play art. Now on defense, these are the people that are designated to who. Look where they're at, okay? You see where everybody is at right here? Everybody's designated there. Everybody's manned aligned. Everybody's where they're supposed to be. If you base align in man defense, watch what happens. Base align the defense. Now look what happens. All you did was create distance in that man defense. So now people that are running drags are gonna have a head start on you. Look at Beasley right there. Okay, he's on a drag. Look what this guy's doing that's guarding him. In-man defense. Okay, now if I reset the play, right? Well, I don't think I can with this controller. I think this controller is broken. But that makes the drag very easy to run against that defense because you're base aligning. Now look at it from without base aligning. So in man defense, you do not want to base align your defense because look what's happening. This guy's got, you know, good distance in man defense against Beasley running that drag route. But if we base align, he backs up. Now he's giving Beasley all that space. Look at that space Beasley gets right there. So you do not want to base align in man defense. I hope that clarifies some of the things up for you guys right there. Like, comment, subscribe, all that good shit. I will check you out on the next one. Peace.